Okay, we are live. So today I'm pretty not today, but a couple days ago I was pretty proud 'cause we have hit affiliate, and I don't know exactly how you get paid, but other than that. Thank you very much. Oh my God. Thank you very much, Shrimpy. All you. Oh my God. Oh jeez. Yeah, I think it's gonna go a while, 'cause yeah. You did that 5 times. Thank you very much for me. Gosh, I think I turned on past broadcast options on, hopefully, and so we're effectively a vibe. Thank you very much, Shrimpy. Gosh, I'll wait for that to. Okay, so I know I need to get the emotes. I'll try and get. Wait, Shrimpy, are you in the chat right now, or was that just a holdover from last time and then it just all went at the same time? No, never mind, you're probably in the chat right now because, what's it called? Because it didn't show you sub last time, but yeah, that I worked on that a little bit today, got that GIF up and running. Got the new bar for subscribers. Got the change the bar up for followers because I think it looks a little bit better. So now we have this subscribe and everything else. I want to get the formalities out of the way, and first is Shin, my moderator. He's he helps me out with mental health, and he helps me out a lot. Anyway, and again, updated Shrimpy's card. Shrimpy helps me out a lot, and he also just gifted five subs to a couple of our friends and two I know from gaming and streaming. So again, thank you very much, Shrimpy. It means a lot. And I think again the last thing I was going to say is try and support this guy's petition on change.org and all that. Regardless, so yeah, hopefully we'll have emotes soon. In fact, maybe I'll try and find an artist soon enough. And I was gonna say you got the gold gift basket. I was like super mystified. Yeah, Shin, you got yeah, Shrimpy just gifted 5 subs, and again, thank you very much, Shrimpy. So, gosh, what else I was gonna say? Oh yeah, I think that's the biggest thing is getting emotes. 'Cause again, like, I swear, like, from like watching other streamers all the time, like. And also Shin, sorry, not to be rude, but watching Shin as well, I was always I always wanted the emote, so I know I'll get on that or I'll try to get the emotes as fast as possible. When oh my God. Oh my God, dude, you don't have to do this. Like, you spent like, is it like $10, $15 or something like this already? Like, I'm just. Oh my God, it's the frames are just going absolutely nuts because the sub drops. I'll just drop this. see all the double images up there, so it wasn't doing like a quad image because I'm having my screen capture right, or not a quad image, like a quad double sound right, or sorry, I know that's just that doesn't. I'm confused. Thank you very much, Shrimpy. Again, I couldn't done it without Shin and Shrimpy and my good friend Spaz friend and. They helped me out so much. They effectively helped me out during my last stream, which I needed to hit three average or three viewer average. So I can't think of the right words. Maybe a good one is ecstatic. I don't know, but I'm just I can't even express my. Or express my thanks and proper words for Shrimpy and Shin and Spazfriend and CSN and so many others I can't so yeah, we'll get those emotes soon. In fact, Shrimpy, I just want to ask, when does yours run out? Because because I want to make sure that I get the emotes in time so that you still have them without having to resub to the thingy or whatever. So what else was I gonna say? I kind of lost my train of thought, but again, thank you very much, Shrimpy. And one other thing I was just gonna say, like, there wasn't any quadruple sound right. That was my other worry. That was because I had the window open and all that, so yeah. When I was gonna ask both of you guys, Shrimpy and Shin, when should I run the ad? Because I was gonna say maybe at 15 minutes. Or maybe there's an ad that already get in here, right? If I'm not mistaken. Gosh, I think this video is enough. Hopefully, again, I think I turned on capture past broadcasts, but I think I did. Hopefully it is on, so I can just, because I was going to do a video on YouTube saying I got affiliated, but I think this video says it enough, so. Well, maybe we won't run an ad this time and just get on with the, or mid ad or whatever, so. Maybe the frames are going nuts, not just because five in a row, but they have what's it called? All right, we are back, I think it's time to invest in a new computer, so. This might be the finale video on the old Dell computer. I know the sub goal says 7. I'll I'll fix that when I am after the stream, but if you guys are back. My computer just like just was like peaced out and was just like no, I'm out. We might have to get a new computer. Before that, I was hoping to get the emotes, but for right now, we'll just talk about Custom Robo. Sorry, I'm just like, I'm still like in awe about Shrimpy dropping at least nine subs, and I think that's like 50, $25. But again, I thank him very much for that. But also that my computer was just like, just was like, peace out, y'all, and yeah. So anyway, Custom Robo was a game for, as it says, only for GameCube, and Custom Robo itself is a series that was very much like, gosh, I'm drawing a blank. Was very much like Fire Emblem that, it was another series more or less kind of st I think started on the Nintendo 64, and it was or f I think Fire Emblem goes a little bit farther back, but more or less they were Japan only exclusive, and then the GameCube was the or not just the GameCube, but also Smash Brothers was the reason, not just Fire Emblem got popular, but also what's it called? Custom Robo got popular, I think, just because of the trophies in the game. So trophies of in Smash Brothers and Marth and Roy from Fire Emblem make the series popular enough so that they release Fire Emblem Path of Radiance on what's it called? GameCube and Custom Robo ba Custom Robo, I think, name itself, but then Custom Robo Battle Battle Revolution, either in America or everywhere else. So Custom Robo is a game where and I have a problem with this very later on, but the game is starts about how you and your father are he works a lot, and then he leaves you with when you're a child, like this special keepsake, this watch. I don't remember what the watch is significance in the later part of the story. I know it's just special. So then years later, you can't live off the your landlord's good graces anymore. So she tells you to more or less get a job. You go to this mercenary outfit called Steelhearts, run by Ernest and Harry, which you'll know about Harry in the next couple, scenes or whatever, and a scientist woman, I can't think of her name, but you'll know that Harry is the standard, he's effectively Brock, but I think Brock looks a little bit more handsome. So I swear Harry, like, if you had to ch pick or choose between Harry or the later character Marcia, that would have been a better like storytelling choice. But anyway, you meet Harry. Harry's sort of like your mentor. He tells you that, and the scientist lady herself as well they tell you that, oh, Custom Robo is this. Custom Robo is two tiny robots fighting in a tiny, any even, in, or you know, in a tiny cube, and they're connected to your brain, or something like that. And that's the long and short of it, or just the gist of it. After you, after Steelheart and after you meet Harry and the scientist woman, because sorry, I forgot to mention, you are heading to the laboratory area to stave off a robbery. Harry, I think the day is done, and then you meet Harry again for a go to the gym and learn how to be a better custom robo pilot or whatever. From what I remember about Custom Robo, I know it's like some, and I sorry, I shouldn't say some. I'm kind of had or dissenting opinion. I remember from two best friends. I think the younger guy said that he didn't like the story too much. The story's okay for what it is. Again, I think you'd be more emotionally invested in the story if you're either Marcia or Harry, because Harry and Marcia are the gosh, what's it called? They're the like they have like more complete arcs than the main player character. Unfortunately, Marcia is there as again, like I was saying, unfortunately, just the sole like girlfriend type character, and Harry is there as like you know your in air quotes your main man or your you know again your mentor. But anyway, I would say the story is kind of in the average area because the guy that they you know they stick you at or they put you as he's really generic. You get to name him like you know most RPG conventions go, but hang on. Gonna take a drink of water. But yeah, it's like they give you a blank slate like most RPGs do, but again, the guy doesn't look too like different. Like he's very standard. He looks very generic. And even when, you know, it's other RPGs that have, you know, a main character and you can rename them to as a goofy or you know serious name or you just prefer you know Titus but at the very least Titus looks very different. Oh gosh, what was I gonna say? Sorry. Big gap in just replying to another friend. Oh no, that's fine. That's fine, Spaz. Cause I think the computer crashed and or I no, it's like Shrimpy might be on the other one as well. I'm not too sure. But anyway, thank you. This won't take long, maybe another 4 or 8 minutes, and I'm just gonna go along the like try and get the big just talk about the rest of the game. Anyway, so it's but again, like Titus looks very different. He has Like, it's my problem with Harry is that he has these like overalls that don't look great. At the very least, Titus's overalls are part like they're not falling off. They're not like they don't look messy. They make the whole outfit. And what I'm trying to get at, I feel like Titus has a more unified look, and your generic starter character as well as Harry. Because again, you could just say Harry and Titus have the same overalls problem, but Harry doesn't look great to begin with. He almost has like a he almost has a mullet and glasses, and I probably ha I if I could find it the images for it, but Harry doesn't look good overall. But what I was saying, it would have been better if you were either playing Harry or Marcia. Harry's problem is that he's a bounty hunter working for Steelhearts, but he has an older police sister that is always annoying him to join the police force. Marcia's plot is that she's an excellent bounty hunter, but she's been mystified since her older brother left for unknown reasons. So both of these characters have more complete arcs. Your main character's arc just has the mystery of why your father left, and that's kind of it. There's no I think, and you don't see any you don't ha see like a full complete picture of the guy, and the characters don't speak. They just have a same thing with like Fire Emblem. They just have like the text, and then they have like their own little like noise associated with the text, like a beep 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 type thing. But again, like I was getting across, brought up the character, sorry. Brought up the characters. The main focal point of the game, Custom Robo, is that you fight in those cubes. Like sorry, I know it's confusing. You fight in those cubes, like I mentioned earlier, and you fight each other. There are specific classifications of bots. There's like the first group is like your basic all-around fighters, and they what's it called? They have like basic stats, and they're average, and that's good. They also have melee attacks, which melee attacks will usually knock down your opponent in one go, and they're usually fantastic. I think the next group is the Agile Flyers group, and they usually have the suits or bots look very from what I remember like feminine, but they're pretty cool. They or no, they're I think they're called Aerial Beauties, and they have greater control in the air, and I think they have a third jump. There's another group, I think it's called it's like a short group. They run really fast on the ground, but unfortunately they can't take a hit. So I think it's either they lose more health per knockdown, or they're just e very easy to knock down. Before I keep on going, when you get knocked down, before getting up again, that's a bad joke. You have a period where it's just you can take extra damage, but then you'll have a like 5 second invincibility, and so it's crucial that you don't get knocked down and that you keep on. You avoid attacks and whatnot. And then there's I think it's my favorite classification, but I don't like picking them. There are models that's kind of called like Funky Big Head. They have weird obtuse shapes. Like I think one's a hamster, and one looks like Japanese like Daruma heads or whatever. And then there's one where it's like Aerial something or other. It's another aerial type group, but every time I think they dash, they can like turn invisible or something like that. And then there's one other group before you get to the illegal ones, which is kind of funny. One group where they just turn into planes, and you could just fly around, and it's hard difficult to hit them. I think it's like with the short running group, They're easy to knock down as well. In the game as well, you have four weapons. Sorry, three weapons and like a pair of like boots. The boots help you out with either jumping or running. But then you have like a bomb and like another launcher that's effectively a bomb too. Some of them can be they launch like overarching shots, which can help you like kind of corner your opponent or kind of, just leave them in the traps. And you have a standard weapon which can kind of range the gamut from hang on. All right, thank you, Shrimpy. Don't worry about it. I think it's definitely it might be a definite time to invest in another computer because it just my computer, the old gray mare, just ain't what it used to be. So, and then you have a main weapon which ranges a gamut from like I think there's like a shotgun and magnum which is very close but they do tons of damage. So sometimes you can whiff which is bad for you. And then there's some which I remember are very powerful and I think they can be just kind of they might be broken but I think you can dodge them easily too because I think one of the end bosses can dodge it really easily. And it's this weapon that like shoots like four or five like icicle swords and then they kind of descend on the guy. So that's kind of all the robots in a nutshell. There are legal parts if you use them in which the definition for illegal in the game is if you use them they can actually damage somebody in real time, so you don't want to use them because they can cause bodily harm. And if you use them in the tournament, which is the next part of the story, you'll get docked down points because they're much powerful or they're much more powerful than their non than their standard counterparts. So, I think the next thing I want to talk about is that the game I think has one of the better musical scores out of a Nintendo game. It has very like almost I would just say it's kind of nerdy, but I would say like 80-ish or the 80s era of music almost of like kind of techno poppy kind of type sounds. So it I think it has great music. The music I think I always remember fondly is the when you're choosing your suit or character or whatever. That's always a catchy tune. And then the ones when you're walking around town, that ones are real those are really good as well. Other than that, what else can I say about the game? I think it's kind of funny that this game and I think Fire Emblem, they don't realize it, but they had two they have two, like two, three of the same names. There's again I mentioned previously, Marcia also there's another character in Fire Emblem with the name Marcia, so. Yeah, I think it's kind of funny. And then there's a character Roy in the game that very much looks like a police knot from Konami. And there's also Roy in Fire Emblem, so they have two of the same people. And then there's one of the villains' name is like, called like Oboro. And in a future Fire Emblem game, there's a character called Oboro. So yeah, it's kind of funny. So they have a little problems with naming conventions. Other than that, I think Custom Robo is a pretty fantastic game if you have a chance to pick it up or have like a GameCube emulator or a Wii or just base GameCube. I think it's a pretty fantastic game if and there's loads of the parts and weapons you can get. Some of them are kind of difficult. One of them is probably my favorite, or well, not favorite, but it at least is worth recognition. There's this part in the game that after or in the tournament part, where after you beat most of the tournaments, because your landlord said the whole time don't go to or never go to her apartment, you finally get a chance to, and it's really funny because they have there's all these models and names of the developers in there, and they doesn't have the best music in there because the music is like from like one of the villainous or from the one of the bosses areas, but it's the models are assigned to developers, and so they kind of have little tidbits like, did you enjoy the game? You know, I designed this character's animation, so. And I was going like, yeah, you know, that's pretty funny. I know it's like it's not in you know super rare for developers to do this, but I think it's just a funny thing. There's even a guy from what I remember, he comes out of like a fridge or whatever, and he says like, oh man, I always had horrible nights because or it might be a guy just on the floor, I can't remember. But he says like, oh man, I always had such horrible nights. I was one of the character designers, and I always had nosebleeds, so there'd always be consistent. Unfortunately, there was always blood on the character's design. So, but anyway, it's even funnier too. There's one of the head guys, I think either you know the director or something, he's there as well, and he says like, oh, you know, or I think he's one of the guys like, did you enjoy the game? And he says a lot of stuff. And then one of the guys, I think the guy that was like one of the character designers, he says, you know, stop talking, executives talks too much. So it's a funny place to be. Why I also bring this up too is that if you talk to a computer in the back, you get a set of parts called like can, and it's just a it's a tin can suit that you can use for a future fight. So there's a reason to go in there besides all the goofy stuff in there. So that's Custom Robo in a nutshell. Again, the story is like it's you know it's average to you know good for what it is. Again, there's no talking like most video games in general, and you know a lot from Japanese, but in fact they don't even have cutscenes like Fire Emblem Path of Radiance, where I think Ike and Mist you know have voice actors for them. So it's a funny game. Again, if you have a chance to play it, I think it's I haven't played it in a while, and I unfortunately I can't, but I would imagine the gameplay has held up. I wouldn't know, because I think I played it maybe like 4 or 5 years ago, so I can't be the best judge because my perception of it has slipped, or my perception is it has you know kind of aged a bit, so I don't know if I be the best judge of it, but I think it's a fun game, so try it if you want to. Thank you again for Shrimpy for dropping all those what's it called? For all the subs or for all the subscriptions, and a thank you for Spazfriend for jumping back in, and Shrimpy as well for jumping back in.